When I think of Tripp, two words come to mind: supremely competent. From day one as a freshman at CMC to the end of his athletic and academic career, he was supremely competent. As I recall, even as a freshman, Tripp made sure to tell the rest of us on the water polo team in those first few days of the season how it was done at Newport Harbor High School. After the 10th or 20th time, we let him know that he was a Stag now, no longer a Newport Sailor. Stags did things this way. Quickly, he got the message. Tripp learned, engaged, leaned in, and led the team in many ways with his supreme confidence, both in and out of the pool. Tripp was all in. He expected a lot from his team and even more from himself. Tripp, you are missed. Go Stags and Athenians.
Today, and over the last few weeks and months, been thinking a lot about Tripp. Coming to funny stories, him flying into your dorm room, sometimes closed, sometimes not, driving out to Palm Springs with Tripp for EJ's wedding. But I keep coming back to the one thing that I remember the most was that incredible smile. And it could be during a game when it was, guys, I got this. It could be a day that you were maybe weren't feeling your best, and he'd give you that smile like, it's gonna be okay, we're gonna get through this together. And I just always loved that about Tripp. What a wonderful guy, wonderful day, and a great honor that we're naming the scoreboard. Thanks.
Two things about Tripp Montgomery. First one, NCAA swim meet at Emory University. Tripp's about to false start. Starter asks the swimmers to stand up. Tripp throws his legs out to the side, lands on the starting block on his chest, hangs on for dear life, never goes in the water, and stays in the race for that day and the rest of the meet. Second thing, that laugh. The most joyous, exuberant, contagious laugh there's ever been. Here's to Tripp Montgomery.
Tripp loved to laugh, and he loved to make people laugh. Whether it was stretching out the punchline for 5 minutes on a van ride coming home from an away game, or pranking you, Tripp's sense of humor was something to behold. And Tripp had the uncanny ability to make himself pass gas on command. We sat in class one day in the back row. He started bouncing up and down in his chair. That's how he loaded the chamber. And he cracked off a window-shattering sonic boom that caused Professor Massoud to stop writing mid-sentence. And he and the rest of the class turned around to look. As we sat there in the back giggling, Tripp smacked me on the back and exclaimed, "Good one, Bri." Classic.
Hey, well, we may be getting along in age these days, but I'll tell you what. Memories of Tripp playing water polo with this guy, they're just like they were yesterday. He had my number. He had loved to just donut me whenever he could. I love seeing him shoot on me. Better than that, I love seeing him shoot on other teams. And there's many a time where he would point up at the scoreboard, look at the other team, and simply say, "Scoreboard." And that was Tripp. So I think there's a certain karma in having the scoreboard dedicated to Tripp, and it's something that's going to last forever in his name and in his memory. So Carla, Dad, Sandy, I hope you really enjoy this as much as we are as teammates of Tripp. But a great guy.
Where do we go now? Where do we go?